ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமஹ. வெல்கம் டு அவர் ஆன்லைன் டீச்சிங் அகாடமி ஏ கலைவா. போர்ட் சிபிஎஸ்சி கிளாஸ் 5 சப்ஜெக்ட் ஈவியர்ஸ். நேம் ஆஃப் த லெசன் இஸ் அவர் நேஷன் இந்தியா. அட் த எண்ட் ஆஃப் த செஷன் யூ வுட் ஹவ் லேர்ன்ட் அபவுட் லொகேஷன் ஆஃப் இந்தியா, இந்தியாஸ் நெய்பரிங் கண்ட்ரீஸ், ஸ்டேட்ஸ் அண்ட் யூனியன் டெரிட்டரிஸ், ஜியோகிராஃபிக்கல் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் ஆஃப் இந்தியா. What is unity in diversity? Unity in diversity. India is the only country which has religions, languages, culture, and completely different geographical location and still stands as one integrated nation. In terms of religion, we say that India is predominantly a Hindu society or Hindu nation, but still we have other religions like Jainism, Buddhism, Sikhism, Islam, Christianity. So there are many religions that are prevalent across the country. In terms of language, a person in Kerala would speak Malayalam language, a person in Punjab would speak Punjabi language, a person in Gujarat would speak Gujarati language. So here you can see different languages depicting the diversity. Diversity is not only in the terms of languages and religions, but it can be in terms of clothes, looks, or food of people. But still people of India live together with love and brotherhood, even though people live unity with each other and living in a peaceful manner. People celebrate religious festivals with great enthusiasm. That's why unity in diversity is unique to our nation. So children, we can proudly say we are Indians. As you are the future generation of India, you have to maintain this unity in diversity by respecting each other's choices as well as their religion, languages, culture. Despite having difference of opinion, let them express their view and give them their space and time. So children, I hope you follow. Which is the largest continent in the world? Asia is the largest continent in the world and comprises of about 30% of the Earth's total land area. You all know that there are 7 continents and 5 oceans in the world. Here the blue color denotes the oceans, that is Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean, Arctic Ocean. These are the 5 oceans. Rest of the other places are land area. North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Asia, Antarctica, Australia. These are the 7 continents. So out of these land area, our Asia occupies 30% of the land area. Can you guess how many countries in Asia? There are 50 countries in Asia. Our India is a part of Asia. It is located in the southern part of Asia. Let's learn about India. India is the 7th largest country in the world in terms of area. It is the second populated country in the world after China. So China is the first populated country in the world. In 2019, the estimated population of India is approximately 1.36 billion people. India covers an area of about 3.28 million square kilometers. It means 2.4% of the Earth's total land area. India stretches from Kashmir in the north to Kanyakumari in the south and Arunachal Pradesh in the east and deserts of Kutch in the west. Let's see the location of India. From south to north, it stretches from 8 degree 4 minutes north to 37 degree 6 minutes north. From west to east, 68 degree 7 minutes, east to 97 degree 25 minutes east longitude. Here the vertical line is known as longitude. Here the horizontal line is known as latitude. Here the location of longitude and latitude shows the east and north direction. In the previous session, you learned that the line that runs exactly in the middle, thereby dividing the earth into two halves, is called equator. So, the 0° latitude is called equator. The part of the earth above the equator is called northern hemisphere. The part below it is called southern hemisphere. The line which runs from north pole to south pole is called prime meridian. That is, 0° latitude, longitude is called prime meridian. 0° longitude is called prime meridian. This line divides the earth into two halves, that is eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. Look into the map, children. Here the location of India is completely in the northern and eastern hemisphere. Not in the south or west, it is totally in the northern and eastern hemisphere. Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer runs in the middle at 23 degrees 30 minutes north. It divides India into two halves, that is northern India and southern India. The northern part of the India is surrounded by the land. The southern part of the India is surrounded by the water. That is Arabian Sea in the west, and Bay of Bengal in the east, and Indian Ocean in the south. India is the only country in the world which has ocean in its name. Now let's learn about coastline. Coastline means the area where the land meets the ocean or sea is called coastline. Here the land meets the ocean. This is called coastline. It begins from Gulf of Kutch in the west and ends at the West Bengal in the east. The total length of this coastline is 7,517 kilometers. It also includes Andaman and Nicobar Islands in the east and Lakshadweep Island in the west. Our neighboring countries. India shares a border with many countries whom we call neighbors. Our neighboring countries are Nepal, Bhutan, China, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Sri Lanka. Here, the boundary of India is here. Here you can see the boundary of India. Afghanistan and Pakistan lie to the north and northwest. China, Nepal, Bhutan lie to the north and northeast. Then Bangladesh and Myanmar to the east. Next Andaman and Nicobar, then Sri Lanka in the south. So these are the neighboring countries of India. After passing of the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019 with effect from 31st October 2019, India had 28 states and 9 union territories. In December 2019, the union territories of Dadra Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu were merged. Now India has 28 states and 8 union territories. And it came into effect on 26 January 2020. Here we have a beautiful, lovely picture of India political map. We can see all the state boundaries and also the capital cities associated with the respective states in different colors. Here we have map legend. The international boundaries are marked with the pink color. The state boundaries are marked with the white color. Capital of India, that is Delhi, is marked with the red dot. All the capitals of India is marked with the black dot. For example, Maharashtra capital is Mumbai. Mumbai is marked with the black dot. And Madhya Pradesh capital is Bhopal. Bhopal is marked with the black dot. Each state has its own capital. But the states of Punjab and Haryana share a common capital, Chandigarh. Union territories. We have two sets of government. One is central government, other one is state government. Central government works for the whole country. State government looks after the states. However, union territories are governed by the central government. Now we are going to mark the union territories of India. Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir, Chandigarh, Delhi. So Chandigarh and Delhi is not only the capital, it is also a union territory. Next, Puducherry, Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Lakshadweep Islands. Here you have Diu, Daman, Dadra Nagar and Haveli. So as per the 2020 Act, as per the Act 2020, Daman and Diu and Dadra Nagar were merged. They became one union territory. So totally we have 8 union territories. India is one of the most beautiful places on the earth, known as the land of rivers and diverse topography. So what is meant by topography, children? Topography means arrangement of physical features of an area. Physical features, or you can say geographical features. Let's see the geographical features of India. You have lofty Himalayas, the great Gangetic Plains, the great Deccan Plateau, the great Indian Desert, and the scenic coast. Next session, we will learn about this geographical features of India. See you soon, children. To receive our online lessons, please press subscribe button. You will receive latest updates. Thank you.